This is a pre-built version of the application. So let's go ahead and start three command prompts. And one of them will have the server, and the other two will have two clients. And let's set the path to where we have our Python, and this one will run the server, and this one the first client, and this the second one. Now the Diffie-Hellman key exchange allows two parties, Alice and Bob, to jointly establish a shared secret key over an unsecure network. So passive Eve here can see all their communications. So P is a prime number, and alpha is a primitive root modulo P. And Alice and Bob agree to use P equal to 23 and alpha equal to 5. And for the purpose of this prototype project, we had the first user that logs in, Alice in this case, enter the values for P and alpha. And Alice chooses a secret key and sends Bob the calculated public key, uppercase A, and Bob does the same thing. He chooses a secret key and sends Alice the calculated public key, uppercase B. So uppercase A is congruent to alpha to the power of lowercase a in mod P, so 5 to the power of 4 in mod 23, and we end up with 4 mod 23. And uppercase B is congruent to alpha to the power of lowercase b in mod P, so 5 to the power of 3 in mod 23, and we end up with 10 mod 23. And Alice computes the shared secret key S, and Bob does the same thing. So here S is congruent to uppercase B, the public key of Bob, to the power of the private key of Alice in mod P, so 10 to the power of 4 in mod 23, so we end up with 18 mod 23. And here S is congruent to the public key of Alice to the power of the private key of Bob in mod P, so 4 to the power of 3 in mod 23, so same thing, 18 mod 23. So Alice and Bob now share a secret key, which is this, and only lowercase a and lowercase b and the shared secret key are kept secret, and all other values are available to everybody to see. So passive Eve here can see them. So she can see P and alpha, and the public key of Alice, uppercase A, and the public key of Bob, uppercase B. Now much larger values of lowercase a, lowercase b, and p would be needed to make this example secure. And Eve needs to solve the discrete logarithm problem in order to find lowercase a or lowercase b, and then use either one of those to calculate the shared secret key. And for large numbers, this is very hard to do. Next, and before proceeding with the code, let's do a quick introduction. So we will be using the multiplicative cyclic group Z star P, where P is prime and alpha is a group generator, and we have two secret keys, lowercase a and lowercase b, and possible values for those are 2 to p minus 2. So what is a group? What is a cyclic group? And what is a group generator? And how are those concepts of group, cyclic group, and group generator related to the discrete logarithm problem? And how is that in turn related to the Diffie-Hellman problem? Also, why do we start from 2 to p minus 2 instead of 1 to p minus 1. So a group G with multiplication operation is made up of a set G with binary operation, multiplication on G, where the group operation is closed. And that means that if we have A and B in G and we multiply them, then we end up with C, which is also in G. And the group operation is associative. So A times B times C is equal to A times B times C for all A, B, C in G. And there is an identity element 1 in G, where A times 1 is equal to 1 times A is equal to A for all A in G. And for each A in G, there exists an element A minus 1 in G called the inverse of A, where A times A minus 1 is equal to A minus 1 times A is equal to 1. And a group G is abelian, meaning commutative, if A times B is equal to B times A for all AB in G. So here we will find out what is a cyclic group and what is a group generator. So we have this group that starts from 1 to P minus 1 to 12. And alpha is 2 is a group generator in mode 13. So if we take alpha to the power of 1, we end up with 2. Alpha to the power of 2, we end up with 4 in mode 13. And alpha to the power of 3, we end up with 8, etc. until alpha to the power of 12. We end up with 1 in mode 13. And if we look at those numbers, they end up being this group. So alpha equal to 2 generates this group, and same thing for alpha equal 6, 7, and 11. They are all generators of Z star 13. And for the cyclic part, here we start from 2 and we end with 1, and same thing here, we start from 2, then 4, and we end with 1, etc. So we are cycling through those numbers in this group. Next, let's do a quick proof of the Diffie-Hellman key exchange. So we can obtain the shared secret key by having the public key of Alice to the power of the private key of Bob, or the public key of Bob to the power of the private key of Alice. So we want to show that those two are the same. So uppercase A to the power of B is equal. So this would be alpha to the power of lowercase a and to the power of B. And we take those two here. So alpha to the power of A times B, and we flip them. So alpha to the power of B times A, and then we move B here. So alpha to the power of B, and all of that to the power of A. And alpha to the power of lowercase b is equal to uppercase B. So that would be to the power of A. So those two are the same. Now, somebody that is passively monitoring the communication between Alice and Bob has to solve the discrete logarithm problem in order to discover the common key that they both generated. And this problem is that given P and beta in Z star P and a generator alpha, what is x, where alpha to the power of x is congruent to beta in mode p? And if p is large enough, this is a computationally very hard problem. Now, the Diffie-Hellman problem is that we know the generator alpha and the prime number p and the public keys uppercase a and uppercase b, and the unknowns are the private keys lowercase a, lowercase b, and the common key. And our goal is to obtain the common key, which is alpha to the power of lowercase a to the power times b. So alpha to the power of a times b. And one way to solve the Diffie-Hellman problem is to compute lowercase a from uppercase a, or lowercase b from uppercase b, using discrete logarithm. And it is not proven that solving the discrete logarithm problem is the only way of solving the Diffie-Hellman problem. And we can generalize the discrete logarithm problem so that instead of the operator on that group is multiplication, we can have also addition. So this would be either multiplication or addition. So alpha is the generator and beta is in G, and we need to find x where beta is equal to alpha, and this would be either multiplication or addition, and this would be x times. And if we have multiplication, it would be alpha to the power of x. And if it is addition, it would be x times alpha. And addition is what we use with elliptic curve. Next, let's quickly go over why we pick the secret keys from 2 to p minus 2 instead of 1 to p minus 1. So 1 and p minus 1 are not used in practice, since for g with multiplication operation we have alpha and then alpha to the power of 2, alpha to the power of 3, etc. until alpha to the power of p minus 1. And with Fermat little theorem, alpha to the power of p is congruent to alpha mod p, which means that alpha to the power of p minus 1 is congruent to 1 in mod p. And for a is equal to p minus 1, uppercase a is equal to alpha to the power of lowercase a is equal to 1. And Eve can conclude that the secret key of Alice is equal to p minus 1, and for a is equal to 1, uppercase a is equal to alpha to the power of lowercase a is equal to alpha. And Eve here can conclude that the secret key of Alice is equal to 1. Now the source code will be available for download. Also a longer version that includes the coding and test running of the coded application will be available for watching by all channel members.